Imagine that you have a set of 2D points, and you want to find the line that passes from the most points. That's what the max points on a line problem is about. We have a list of 2D points, and we want to find the maximum number of points that lie on the same line. In the example below, it's 5, because we have a line that passes from 5 points. Note that all points are unique. How to solve this problem? We can think of a brute force solution where we traverse all the existing lines while keeping track of the maximum number of points passed by one of them. But it's just impossible, because there is an infinite number of lines, your solution would never stop. The number of lines that passes from 0 or 1 point is infinite, but the number of lines that passes from 2 points or more is not. We can have at most 1 per each couple of points. In other terms, for each couple of points, there exists only one line that passes from both of them. And because we're searching for the line with the maximum number of points, we can just ignore those with 0 or 1 point. Okay, but how to find lines we're interested by? For that, we just traverse each couple of points and see what unique line they have in common. For example, here for the couple AB we have this line. For the couple AC we have this line, for the couple AD we have this line, for BC this one, for BD this one, and for CD this one. We want to find the line that passes from the most points, so we can think of a hash table where the key is a line and the value is a set of points that it passes by. To fill it, we do what we just did, traverse couples of points, for each one of them, we found the common line, and we add the 2 points to a set of points. For example, for the couple AB, their common line is this one, so we add A and B to its points in the hash table. And for the couple AC, their common line is this one, so we add A and C to its points. Then for the couple AD, their common line is the same as for the couple AB. This is why A and D will be added to the same line. This line now has 3 points it passes from, A, B, and D. Which is true, this line passes from 3 points. And so on for remaining couples. After doing so for all couples, we just check the one with most points in the hash table. Its length represents the max number of points on a line. Okay, but how to represent a line? And how to find the common line of 2 points? A 2D line can be represented with 2 elements, its slope and its intercept. The slope is a number that describes its direction and its steepness, and the intercept is the value it passes from in the y-axis. Second question, how to find the slope and the intercept of the common line of 2 points? We have coordinates of 2 points x0, y0 and x1, y1. The slope is how much the y value changed divided by how much the x value changed. Calculating that value tells us if we change x by 1, by how much y will change. The formula is y1 minus y0 divided by x1 minus x0. For example, with the points 4, 5 and 6, 9, we get 9 minus 5 divided by 6 minus 4, which gives 2. And for the intercept, now that we have the slope, we can subtract how much y changes multiplied by the distance from 0. For example, here the slope is 2, and at x equal to 4 we have y equal to 5. So at x equal to 3 we have y equal to 3. At x equal to 2 we have y 1. At x1 we have y minus 1. And at x equal to 0 we have y equal to minus 3. So the intercept is minus 3. What we did is that we started from y0 and we subtracted the slope x0 times. So the intercept is y0 minus slope multiplied by x0. We now know how to calculate the slope and the intercept, but we have two edge cases. When the line is horizontal and when the line is vertical. The line is horizontal when y0 is equal to y1. In that case, the y doesn't change, so the slope is 0. And the intercept is equal to y0 and y1, because the y doesn't change. So the key is 0, y0. And the line is vertical when x0 is equal to x1. In that case, the slope is undefined because we're dividing by 0, and the intercept doesn't exist because it never crosses the y-axis. The only thing that makes it different from other vertical lines is the x, so we take x0, x1, they're equal. Now if we want to make a function that returns, let's say, the id of a line, it takes as parameters x0, y0, x1, and y1. If y0 is equal to y1, we know that the slope is 0 and the intercept is y0. We return the tuple 0, y0. Else if x0 is equal to x1, the line has an undefined slope, because x1 minus x0 is 0 and we cannot divide by 0. And no intercept, because it doesn't pass from the y-axis. The only characteristic is the x, so we put x0, x1, they have the same value. We can also add null as a second characteristic to keep the same return type. Else, it means that we have a regular line. The slope is y1 minus y0 divided by x1 minus x0, and the intercept is y0 minus slope multiplied by x0. We return both values. Note that we don't have the case where x0 is equal to x1 and y0 equal to y1 because the problem says that all points are unique. Okay, now we're ready to solve the problem. Our function takes as parameter points, an array of 2D points. If it has only one point, then the maximum points on a line is 1, we directly returned 1. That's an edge case. Now we create our hash table, where the key is characteristics of a line, and the value is a set that contains points it passes from, a set to not have duplicates. This is why we create a hash table where the default value is a set. We can start traversing couples. For each index I starting from 0, for each index j starting from I plus 1, to avoid traversing the same couples, we have the points of I and points of j. Points of I holds x0 and y0, and points of j holds x1 and y1. Next step, we need to add both of them to their common line, that we can find by using the function we just made. We call it, and in that key in the hash table, we add both points. We can add, for example, their indexes I and j. After the loop, line's hash table is now filled, we just need to find the line with the most points and take its length. For that, we can put all the lengths in an array and take the maximum among them. It represents the maximum number of points on a line. And we solved our problem. For the time complexity, finding characteristics of a line requires simple calculations. The cost is O of 1. We also have nested loops to traverse couples, and we have n points, so the time complexity is O of n squared. Note that this solution assumes that there is no floating point errors, which is not always the case. If you want to avoid them, instead of calculating the slope and the intercept, you can just let them as simplified fractions, simplified by dividing by the GCD, the greatest common divisor. We've reached the end of this lecture. I hope that you understood the solution to this problem. If you want to support the channel, you can like and subscribe, or you can buy one of the courses in the description. See you in the next one.